Hi, this is Dr. JMR, JMR Chemistry. Today I am going to explain water as an acid as well as a base. So here generally one terminology generally will introduce, that is amphoteric. What is amphoteric? Amphoteric substance means generally it acts as a acid as well as base, then we can call it as amphoteric. Generally here water is a amphoteric in nature. Why water is a amphoteric nature? It is acts as a acid then a base. So here this is known as a new terminology is entered, that is auto ionization. What do you mean by auto ionization? Auto ionization means self transfer of protons, accepting protons and donating protons. That is known as auto or self ionization. Suppose for example water react with water to form H3O plus, then plus OH minus ion. So here it contains generally two lone pair of electrons naturally, and here it is ready to donate one lone pair of electrons. It is converted into only one lone pair. OH minus ion contains what beta? Three lone pair of electrons, so that is why that is minus. This we can call it as self ionization. This is H plus ion, we can call it as donor. H plus ion, donor, and this is H plus ion acceptor. So here this is donor and this is ready to donate proton and it is ready to accept. So generally proton donor, then we can call it as acid. Then here we can call it as base. Why? Proton acceptor. Proton acceptor, we can call it as water. Base, this is an acid. So here water acts as acid as well as base. So suppose for example, HCl dissolved in water to form H3O plus and Cl minus. To form water, H3O plus ions and Cl minus. So this acts as an acid. Why? This is proton donor. This is proton donor and this acts as a base. Why? Proton acceptor. This is proton acceptor. So here water acts as a base in this reaction. Water acts as a base in this reaction. Suppose you take NH3, react with water. So naturally what happened? It is converted into NH4 plus, then plus OH minus. Means here proton is ammonia is attracting proton and here water is donating proton. This acts as an acid, this acts as a base. Means in this reaction, suppose in first case what happened, water acts as a base in this reaction. In second reaction water acts as a acid, here acid and here base. So that is why we can call it as water is amphoteric substance. It is donating and here accepting. So it acts as a amphoteric nature. And here we can say that is self-ionization. That is very important. Self-ionization. It is nothing but water react with water indirectly. Water react with water to form water H3O plus ions plus OH minus. This we can call it as self-ionization. Or you take another example for self-ionization. Ammonia react with ammonia solution. So, it is dynamic equilibrium to form ammonium ion plus NH2 minus. So, this is known as what a self-ionization. Self-ionization. This we can call it as self-ionization. So, like this, water react with water to form hydronium ion and hydroxide ion, and ammonia react with ammonia to form water. Ammonium ion and water amine. So like this is known as self-ionization. Suppose we'll go back into the water. So in water here to form H3O plus ions and OH minus ions. In self-ionization at 25 degree centigrade, the concentration of H3O plus ions and OH minus ions are equal. They are dynamic equilibrium. At 25 degree centigrade, the concentration is 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 m at 25 degree centigrade. So here, naturally you will get at 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7. The concentration of H3O plus ions and OH minus ions is known as what? Ionic product. Ionic product of water. So, this is known as ionic product of water. So, ionic product of water is denoted by Kw. Ionic product of water is denoted by Kw. How? The concentration of H3O plus ions and the concentration of OH minus ions is known as ionic product of water. This is also known as ion product constant. This Kw, we can call it as what? Ion product constant. This is also we can call it as dissociation constant. So indirectly, the concentration of H plus ions and the concentration of OH minus ions is nothing but here, for example, concentration of H plus ions is equals to, they must be equilibrium. Why? So what if they are neutral towards litmus paper? So that is why the H plus concentration as well as OH minus concentration are equal. They are equals to 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 m. So here, then if means they are equal. Suppose if H plus concentration decreases, automatically H3O plus ion concentration is what increases. Why? This H plus ion concentration as well as OH minus concentration, they must be equal to Kw. That is what beta? 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 what into 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 is nothing but 1 into 10 to the power of minus 14. That is, concentration of H plus as well as concentration of OH minus must be what equal to 1 into 10 to the power of 14. So that is the concentration of ionic product of water. This is about what beta? If we'll go into the deep, that is a problems. Suppose in acidic solutions, that is H3O plus ions, in acidic solutions, H3O plus ions is greater than what you call 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 m. And OH minus ions, what happened, is lesser than 1 into 10 to the power of minus 7 m. This is regarding how to calculate the H plus and OH means already here H plus concentration plus OH minus concentration is equals to what beta? K Kw. By using this formula, you can easily calculate the ionic product of water, so our dissociation constant. Thank you.